focus. The people of Nineveh believed God. Nineveh was the capital of Assyria, one of the most violent nations of antiquity. Indeed, it is not surprising that the enormity of the people's sins would invite the anger of God. However, the first reading reveals the infinitely merciful nature of God. Despite Nineveh being a Gentile city, He is not willing to destroy it without first giving it a chance to repent. This story teaches us three things. First, the Ninevites were convicted of their sins. They did not justify them or try to make excuses. Second, they trusted in God's mercy. Jonah did not ask them to repent. Still, they believed that should they repent and ask God for mercy, they would be forgiven. Third, they tried to atone for their sins by fasting and wearing sackcloth, the humble garment of repentance. The king himself led by example. We too are guilty of many sins, even if we think we are minor or excusable. And the sins of our community, crime, murder, sexual sin, corruption, all invite the wrath of God. At least now, with COVID-19 upon us, let us repent. Let us, like the Ninevites, look to the one who is greater than Jonah, Jesus, the Son of God, and beg him for mercy. Ruth, today I will ask the Holy Spirit to convince me of my sins and truly repent. I will try and atone for them through small sacrifices.